Assalamualaikum. Okay. Hi guys. Now, I'm to a lecturer about second law of thermodynamics. Okay. The first of all, we're going to the introduction to the second law of thermodynamics. Okay. Before we go into the second law of thermodynamics, may I recall back about the first law of thermodynamics that we learned in chapter 4 and chapter 5. Okay. The first law of thermodynamics consists energy analysis of energy analysis of closed system. Okay, this first about the graph. Okay, this is graph for PV, pressure and volume. Okay, for the sector in chapter 4, we learn about isobaric, polytropic, and about general. And isothermal. Okay, these four segments has their own formula. Okay, we start with isobaric formula. The isobaric formula is W equal to B bracket V2 minus V1. Okay, for polytropic, also the W equal to V2 minus V1 over 1 minus M. Okay, this will have condition that M not equal to 1. Okay, for the general formula, W equal to rho P dV. Okay, the last one is isothermal. Isothermal equal to W P1 ln V2 over V1. Okay, this all what we that cover the first law of thermodynamics and others. Okay, in chapter 4, what is the energy transfer as a force act on a system through distance? Okay. Come back for chapter 5. Chapter 5 is about mass and energy analysis of control volume. Okay, for example, the control volume. Okay, show you the example of control volume. Okay, that. We learn about E note, A, virtue, up, okay, virtue, DT, right? Oh, sorry, this DE over DT. Okay, this is go to zero because steady. Steady flow, for the steady flow. Okay, the second law of thermodynamics, the energy has quality as well as quantity. But in the first law, the quality is not covered in the first law, but in the second law, the quality is take part in the second law. Okay, as the first law, only quantity of energy and transformation of energy with no regard to its quantity. Okay, but for the second law of thermodynamics, the others, we can learn about the technical limit for the performance. Okay, now we're going to the topic number 2. There is thermal energy residual. Okay, for the example of thermal energy residual, the supply energy in front of heat and the thermal energy source will be fit, and then the heat is absorbed by the thermal energy field. It absorbs the energy in front of heat. Okay, this is what thermal energy residual. For the example, in environment, you can see a seesaw that has thermal energy residual. If high temperature because of irresponsible management of waste energy cause is called thermal pollution. Okay, thermal pollution is very dangerous for human or community, because this may cause some disease that can kill human and the other habitat and animal also. Okay, so we need to prevent before. But now the more pollution is quite happen all around the world, so we need to take action about this. Okay, we're going to subtopic number 3. That is heat engine. Okay, heat engine, converting heat to work, require the use of some special device. That's what called heat engine. We need some special device to converting the heat.
Hey guys, we continue to the subtopic number 3 about heat engine. Okay, heat engine is converting heat to work, require some special device. Before we can convert the heat, we need some special device that called heat engine. Before I show you the system of heat engine, I want to show some example about work and heat and heat to work. Okay. experience. This this date is will be rotate because there is work applied to the blade. So when this helps a work to the blade and it rotate, and this tank will release heat. Okay, this is what I mean. What? Release heat. And if we reverse this condition, this heat this heat transfer to the tank and there is no work. This because heat cannot transfer and to make the plate to rotate, because this is very impossible. That will be impossible if we had some device that I call heat engine. That is, we need some special device to rotate this plate, what we call heat engine, that I taught you really. Okay, we got. I'm going to take some example for system of heat engine. Okay, the example for some special device, that is the engine. Okay, from the high temperature source that transfer to this device, and it will cut off this and it will absorb to the low temperature. I call it C. And from this QA to the some special device, and we get up and this one work done. That we transfer to the other some device that can make a work. What just earlier that I mentioned that the plate. Okay, so this, if we located the heat engine here and we transfer high temperature to low temperature, and this will release some work to complete the system. Okay, this is what we call heat engine. So heat can make to work. Okay, this is some formula. Okay, for open system. Thank you. closed system. Okay, ini satu topik nombor 3. The other topic is about thermal efficiency. Okay, what is thermal efficiency? The we calculate the thermal efficiency by use some formula. For thermal efficiency, 1 minus Q out of your heating of net work output over factor heat. Okay, I'll show you some example for the calculation of thermal efficiency. There is a system heat source and heat absorber. Hi guys, we continue to the subtopic number 4, is refrigerator and heat pump. Okay, for the refrigerator have our one system. Okay, I will show you the system of refrigerator. The refrigerator have boiler. For high temperature and is
evaporometer. I'm just gonna expansion. Okay, the flow of the heat. This is the flow of the heat. Okay. Okay, this is what's look like a system of refrigerator. Okay, but the most important thing, the this is the refrigerator space. A transfer heat from low temperature. Okay, this is low temperature, medium to the high temperature. Okay, refrigerator is to remove the low temperature from the cool space. Yes, we remove the low temperature to the cool space. Okay, another thing for refrigerator is to supply heat. Is heat the QH into the warmer space. This is the region of the warmer space. Okay, point number four is to extract energy from the cool outdoor and carry it into the warm indoor. Okay, this is another type of refrigerator. Okay, I will show you this type. Okay, this heat transfer from cool outdoor into the system. Okay, what I talk about this system, this system just same like this, the refrigerator system. Okay, from the cool outdoor into the system, and the system come out is the heat. This QH, QH is high temperature. Okay, we talk all about the okay, the system is kind of what we call this refrigerator, and this is heat pump exactly. And then this is the heat pump system. I'm sorry, the area estate is another refrigerator system, but this is called heat pump. And then it is heat pump. Okay, this is for heat pump. Okay, that's all for the refrigerator and heat pump, and we're going. And I proceed to the coefficient. The coefficient of performance. The point is COP. Okay, for the refrigerator. Refrigerator COP. This is your result. Over fire input. Okay.
In the first law cyclic refrigerator, there is another formula. In the first law. Okay, for the CRP, the desired result, what I mean is desired result is about the QL, and for the required input is the unit. Okay, this is all for refrigerator. Refrigerator CRP. Okay, we pass it to the heat pump COP. Okay, this is for heat pump COP. Heat over what done, that is unit, or equal to heat over high temperature minus low temperature. That is another formula, that is okay, it is combined with COP of refrigerator. After we find the COP of refrigerator, and we can get also the COP of heat pump. Okay, that's all for COP. Okay, we can talk about statement. There is two professor that make a statement about the second law. There is first statement is Kelvin Plan statement. What is say about Kelvin Plan statement? It is impossible. Possible for any device. This statement made by Kelvin Plan. Kelvin Plan. It is impossible for any device that operates on a cycle to receive heat from a single reservoir and produce a net amount of heat. What it means here, I'll show you some example. Okay, this is an example for Kevin Plan statement. From 100% of heat and it's last the only 70% because the environment effect. Okay, there's half loss of the environment and the other effect. Okay, for the second statement is made by Clausius statement. And what he said is okay, this statement made by Clausius. What it say is it is impossible to construct a device that operates in a cycle and produce no effect other than the transfer of heat from low temperature to high temperature. Okay, this device both statement have to say that a negative cannot be proved. Okay, what mean that cannot be proved? That is a statement make a requirement about a device. That is something device that cannot be approved by the statement. Guys, we continue to the subtopic number 6 is about reversible and irreversible process. Okay, reversible process. What's mean by reversible process? A reversible process defined as a process that cannot be revised. Yeah, I'm sorry, that cannot be reversed without leaving any trace on the surrounding. That is, both the system and the surrounding are returned to their initial state at the end of the rebirth process. This is possible only if net heat and net work exchange between the system and the surrounding is zero for the combined original and rebirth process. Processes that are not reversible are called irreversible process. They will explain after this. Okay, for the reversible process, I will show you the example for the reversible. There is a pendulum. Okay, the pendulum is moving. Okay, there is reversible process. That is going up and going down. And another example is like this. There is can be expansion and compression for this device. Okay. Compression, expansion. Okay, this what for reversible process. Okay, the concept of reversible leads to definition of the second law efficiency. for actual process, which is the degree of approximation to the corresponding reversible process. This enables us to compare the performance of different devices that are designed to do same task on the basis of their efficiency. The better the design, the lower the irreversible and higher the second law efficiency. Okay, for the irreversible, the factor that cause a process to be irreversible are called irreversibilities. They include friction, unrestrained expansion, mixing of two fluid, heat transfer across a finite temperature difference, electric resistance, inelastic deformation of solid, and chemical reaction. The presence of any this effect renders a process irreversible. A reversible process involves none of this. Some of frequently encountered irreversible are discussed briefly. Okay, we discuss about the irreversible have between the friction. Friction is similar from a irreversible accelerated with body in motion. Okay, for the example of the friction. Okay, this is really cap case in here. And when this move between the this area, this type of friction when it is moved and going down. Okay, the smaller temperature difference between two bodies, the smaller heat transfer rate will be. Any significant heat transfer through a small temperature difference require a very large surface area and very long time. Therefore, even enough approaching reversible heat transfer is desirable from a thermodynamic point of view. Practically not economically feasible. Okay, this smaller temperature transfer. Okay, this is for tank and this is some heat. It's about 20 degrees and this 50 degrees. Okay, this may occur heat transfer from high to low, and this for 2 degrees. From 5 degrees, 2 degrees Celsius, and this is also 20 degrees Celsius. Transfer in the can from heat. This is the environment heat. Okay, this is what I talked about. The smaller the temperature difference between two bodies. Okay, execution of the Carnot cycle in a closed system. Okay, there is some example for the closed system for the Carnot cycle. Okay, same
example about this.
Yeah, close sister.
Okay, that here an energy source. Energy source in here. And this is your fourth step of Kana Cycle. Okay, the last. Okay, maybe isolated in here. It's a step. It move. Okay. From here to here. Okay. Gas is have different temperature. Area this is what called about TL and T2 TH. Okay, this isolated for the closed system. Okay, for the Carnot, for the reverse Carnot cycle, this is some graph. PV graph for the Carnot cycle. This type of graph. This is from the Q hash. Come from here. And this is for QL. Okay, this T hash is constant and this temperature also constant. What we have in this area is W. This is Carnot cycle PV diagram. Okay, the Carnot cycle principle. First, the efficiency of irreversible heat engine is always less than efficiency of reversible one operating between the same two reservoir. Okay, second, the efficiency of reversible heat engine operating between the same two reservoir are the same. Okay, proof of the first Carnot principle. Okay, this we require a diagram. It's about efficiency of irreversible heat engine is always less than that of reversible. Okay, for the proof of the second Carnot principle, also use a diagram. All reversible heat engine operating between the same two reservoir are the same. That is the second Carnot principle. Okay, for the second Carnot principle, all reversible heat engine operating between the same two reservoir are the same efficiency. Okay, first, thermal efficiency of reversible heat engine is function of temperature. Second, thermal efficiency is independent of the working fluid being used. Okay, this is efficiency. We need to recall back what early I told you the calculation of and formula about the efficiency. Okay, we going to the subtopic number 9. Okay, this is subtopic. Actually, number 6. Okay, for me, the thermodynamic temperature scale. Okay, first, temperature scale that is independent of the properties of substance being used to measure temperature. Second, offer great convenience in thermodynamic calculation. Okay.
Okay, this temperature scale is called Kelvin scale, and temperature on this scale are called absolute temperature. Okay, for the last subtopic of the second law of thermodynamics is the Carnot heat engine. Carnot efficiency. We talk about Carnot efficiency. What is Carnot efficiency? That Carnot heat engine is most efficient of all heat engine operating between the same high and low temperature reservoir. No heat engine can have a higher efficiency than a reversible heat engine operating between the high and low temperature reservoir. Okay, for the Carnot quality of engine. Okay, first question is how do you increase the thermal efficiency of Carnot heat engine? And the friction of heat engine can be converted to work as a function of source temperature. The second question is about how about for actual heat engine? Okay, the higher temperature of the thermal energy, the higher its quality. That is for the answer. Okay. Okay, the Carnot refrigerator and heat pump. Okay, for this, we talk about the coefficient of performance, COP, again, in the Carnot refrigerator and heat pump. No refrigerator have higher COP than a reversible refrigerator between the same temperature limit. Okay, another COP. The COP of reversible refrigerator of heat pump is the maximum theoretical value for the specified temperature limit. Actual refrigerator or heat pump may approach this value as their design are improved, but they can never reach them. The COP of both the refrigerator and the heat pump decrease as the temperature decrease. More work is required to absorb heat from lower temperature media. Okay, that's all for me. The second law of thermodynamics. Thanks to you all guys that have looked into this video, and please subscribe me. Thank you very much.